offense will be protected and make the extra pass to get it done. The second thing is Kentucky is not shooting the ball well. And from that standpoint, Alabama's defense just got to do one job. Keep Kentucky off second chance points. They can win this game in Alabama.
That's been Kentucky's bugaboo all season long, all right?
The Andrew, the only way you got to do it to make him give the ball up, but he is so tough that if you want to go after him with double teams or put ball pressure on, that's the only way you got to do it to make him give the ball up on every possession.
Boga is only a sophomore. He's an old sophomore. He's going to come out, Chad. That's not much of a secret. And if he is the top,
I think the Huskies are going to really prime for this game. Lose it to Arizona on the road. They beat Arizona three times last year. It'll be the leadership of Nate Robinson to get it done. He averages 16 points a game. He comes up with five assists, and he also gets two steals. This NCAA tournament team last year, the Huskies lost in the first round. They just don't want to get back. They want to move to the Sweet 16. A very veteran team and well-coached.
Just do that. I think they play strategy. They try to, like, play chess in a game. And I give credit to Darius Washington Jr. because when they went to Louisville, John Calipari had him ready to beat the press because they couldn't take the ball off him. They couldn't trap him. And that's why that thing blew out to almost 30 points in the second half. That's the first part of it. Tonight, it's a reverse head game. Now, when you look at Rick Pitino, I'll be shocked if they try to press Darius Washington Jr., and I'll be surprised if they don't play little zone trying to force them beat me from the perimeter the way he did it to Cincinnati when they did that to Jason Maxfield. That strategy worked. Now, understand, Pitino will have a different strategy going this game tonight.
I think they're going to press him. I think they're going to put a full-court press on him and try to get the ball out of the hands of primary handlers, speed him up, and force some turnovers. They only forced 13 turnovers in the last game. They're going to try to force more in this one to get with a speed game.
Well, team that helped himself the most today.
Well, I thought NC State did because they got that win. They need it. They're 6-8 down the conference. They go to Virginia, play Wake at home. They're still right in that picture to try to get in that large.
I thought it was Georgia Tech winning on the road. They still have to go to Wake Forest and play Clemson, but they've won back-to-back games for the first time since January 8th. That's amazing.
All right, flip side, momentum is important, so which team hurt itself the most today?
Pitt's in the
Virginia Tech. I thought they had a good opportunity to beat NC State on the road, but they didn't come with the physical presence that they needed, especially at the guard spot. They didn't guard very well, and they only shot 38% from the field. Only one guy in double figures. That was